Well, hello. You've joined me. I'm in Greece somewhere. I'm not really. My plane is. I'm not. I've forgotten where I am. I'm trying to work out why. I changed all my OBS settings. So, of course, I've lost all my settings. Right, let's have a look. I am in go. Right, I'm just messing with little nav map. Little nav map. There we go. Let's have a look at that bad boy. There it is. Looking to see where I am. I'm just moving windows around and stuff because I can. Well, I'm not there, that's for sure. That's Dresden. I'm definitely not in Dresden. Where's my button? There we go. There we are. What we're doing is we are doing a tour hop of Greece. So my tea's getting cold. I need to find out where we're going. We're going from here. Forgive me for not wanting to pronounce that. Demokritos. We're going. Let's pop that into the. Oh, let's clear the flight plan first. Flight. Set the aircraft as well. I'm gonna. Right, so back to little nav map. We are here. I'm gonna add that to our flight. Because it's a tour flight for the virtual airline, we can pretty much go where we want. Well, not where, we've got to make the destination count. It's got to be a reasonable time, but I'm gonna do a little bit of a longer flight than it is estimated. Estimated at 35 minutes, I'm gonna do probably about 45, maybe. GMT. So we're going to Odysseus. I'm very sorry to any Greeks butchering their language. Very sorry to any Brits for butchering our own language, but you know. Well, that's quite a reason. What is all these airways on for? Let's turn them off. Right, there we go. I think what we need to do. I fancy a flight down the coast, so what we're going to do is we're going to take off from this airport. I'm flying offline, by the way, so I don't need to worry about any air traffic control or anything like that. To be honest, I'm not even going to bother with. Mind you, it's only Class D. Not really going to bother with fixed routes, VFR routes in and out of air spaces. I'm just going to go where the mood takes me. Go down past this, all these lagoons. Along the coast, there's a little town or a city there. That's a town, isn't it? We pass that town. I think what we'll do just after that town. Yeah, we will go. I think we'll follow the coast. We'll do that. Just follow this coastline all the way along. to there. Squeeze down between there. Go out to this point. And then we'll come around through this inlet here. Follow the coast around and land. So, that is going to take us an hour and 10 minutes. That's fair enough. Mind you, that's going to 7,000. We're not going to go that high. We go up to about 3,500. As I said, I'm not following any airway rules or anything today, because I don't want to. I'm just going to go where the mood takes me. Alright, that's the route planned. Let's shut that down. Oh. Recording already on the flight tracker. For anybody that was here for the Elite content, I'll be jumping back on Elite later. I'm just taking a bit of a break. Mostly because I need to do a flight for my VA, once I get booted. Okay, so we are in the Piper, Just Flight Piper Arrow 4, Turbo Arrow 4. We want to turn the battery on, turn the alternator on, put the beacon on. Put the prop pitch up. I'm doing all this from memory, and it's been a long time since I've flown this plane, so I'll probably forget some stuff on the way. But, you know, why the hell not? I'm going to put the strobe on now as well. Let's turn. Oh, we don't have that set, do we? Is the fuel on? That's the question. It is. It's not. It is. It is, yeah. We're on the left tank. Clear prop. We need to put the mixture up, obviously. Nobody told me that. Clear prop again. There we go. Oh, handbrake wasn't on. That was silly, wasn't it? Did that not start? Yee. Ah, missed it. Okay, right. I got the throttle open a little bit more this time. There we go, that's cool. Bring it back down to about 1,000 RPM, as is the standard. We don't appear to have any sound. I've only just noticed that, my apologies. Let's see what is going on here. That is why. Okay, let's cancel that. That's the... Right, okay, I've got the wrong... There we go, you probably can't hear me now. Whilst we're doing that, I'm just going to check my audio levels. Turn that off. Did I turn the right thing off? I don't know. Let's have a look. I did. Perfect. So you can hear me. You can hear the engine. I mean, what else is there to hear? I could probably turn me down. As long as you can hear me over the engine. Let's give it some revs. It's quite a quiet engine, this, anyway. So, yeah, that's fine. Go back to 1,000 RPM. Turn the monitor off as well, because the last thing I want is to hear myself, because I don't like my voice. Right, let's get some more lights on, we've got the taxi lights on. Do we have taxi lights on this? I don't think we do. We don't. No lights. There we go. The problem is, because I've not flown this for so long, I can't remember what some of these switches do. Not an issue though, let's go to the start of the runway. There's a bit of a 3 knot tailwind, so we're probably going to just take off with the wind, because the runway with the wind is closest, basically. Get the chocks taken out from under the wheels so that we can go forward, because if I don't, we won't go anywhere, bloody hell. Chocks and tyre down, there we go, that's them off. Right, let's try that again, shall we? I've got a look at these options, haven't I? Oil fuel, so yeah, that's fine. Right, cool. Right. Roll that engine a bit and brake off. There we go, there we go. That's much better. I have to be very gentle with the pedals. The last big update, introduced a few bugs into my control scheme, so I'm very loath to reinstall, but it's looking like I might have to. Stage of flaps in. Test the brakes. Not working. That's one of the controls that got destroyed. Or it is working. Oh, I don't understand. I'll have to use the key bind for now. Do you know what I haven't done? I'm all over the place. This isn't good. Okay, that's not going to work, is it? Okay, right, we'll look at that another time. Ignore the background noise, I've got a lot of clunking going on here, but it's done now. Right, here we go. We need to heat on. Has that gone on? I mean, we're not doing very well today, are we? No, it hasn't worked, so check that on. Put the landing lights on. They worked, that's good. Throw back, we don't want too much speed, and pop the nose down to a level. So I don't remember how to fly, it's been quite a while. Start trimming for the speed. I'm going to go up to about 2,000, I think. I mean, I could just use the autopilot, but hey, let's actually fly for once. There we go, 2,000 coming up. Oh, that's right, this is really difficult to trim out, isn't it? This aircraft. And then am I actually affecting the trim there? I can't see. So there's the trim wheel. So right down there. Oh yeah, it's very, very small increments. Oop. I think that's it, roughly. Yep, still going up. It's going to be about there, and we'll just keep an eye on the trim as we go. So, we're in Greece, doing Greek tour hops, Fly UK. VA. That's Fly UK VA. What was it? Fly. You should know this. FlyUK.aero. Go and check them out. Great, great VA to fly with. Good community, which I don't take part in nearly enough. They have weekly flights. Weekly group flights. We've got a flying club, which this tour is part of. I'll pop that sound down just a touch in my ears because that is really quite loud. Whoop, whoop. There we go. Getting a bit of height there. We don't really want that. This aircraft, just a flight. Piper. Turbo Aaron, PA28. It's playwear. It's not bad. It's nice. I like it. It's does what it needs to do. Forgotten how to get rid of that. No. I don't know what I just pressed there, but whatever. The engine didn't die, so can't be that bad. I find with these just flight ones, I mean, I'm not a real world pilot by any means, by any stretch of the imagination, but I do find with these that they are very difficult to trim. There we go, got some light. Difficult they are to trim in the real world, I don't know. But, you know, it's one of those things, isn't it? You learn. It's all about practice. I forgot to start my timer, so I don't know when I'm going to have to swap tanks, even though it says I've got automatic fuel tanks switching on. In my experience, it doesn't work. So what we do... left. Oh, okay, it has switch tanks. I'll keep an eye on that. I'm gonna get out just above the sea. So we've got the land just to our left, the beach to our left. I'll do that on this corner that's coming up. You can see my mouse, that's good. I'm gonna... that cloud is right now. I'm gonna adjust the cloud base. Scattered clouds. I'm gonna change that to high level clouds. There we go, that's better. That's like Greece we know and love, isn't it? That's more like it. Some realism today. Now I've got my settings turned down quite low at the moment. My system's not that powerful anyway, but I want to make sure I can enjoy it at least 30 frames per second. So we're going to follow this, this land all the way around into the valley. It's like 30 miles from this headland here into where we'll be turning back to come up the other side. Unless of course I get bored, which is quite possible. very nice. I like them. I do like this. Losing a bit of altitude on that turn. Not really coordinating my turns with my rudder. It's pulling to the left a lot, and I think that's because of the P-torque from the rotor. It's not a helicopter, from the propeller. Whenever I think of Greece, I think of beach holidays and big resorts and stuff like that, I think. I've never been to Greece. My father used to go religiously every year to Greece, different island every year. He used to be, and he looked like a Greek with his great big moustache. Nation of sailors, Greeks. Look at me playing. Okay, man, is the registration on this one? It's like, yeah, you can read that. You don't need me to tell you that. It looks like I'm losing altitude. Very slightly. That's fine. I'll can get a bit nose up trim. Last update, Microsoft Flight Simulator, they introduced a thing where you could have extra windows open. So I activated that to get three windows open, main one and two side ones, so I could have all three of my monitors as a flight sim. And I didn't like it. I really didn't. I don't know why. It was, of course, something that they had in all previous versions of Flight Sim. You know, you've always been able to open extra windows. But for this one, they didn't do it for some reason. Yeah, there's a lot of height there, but well trimmed, so I don't want to adjust that. Going to do another flight in my round the world flight on air, but unfortunately my subscription to On Air ran out, so I need to redo that at the end of the month. Completely forgot about it. But luckily the company is on hold. I'm starting to, lose a bit of patience with On Air because I started using it a while ago now, but when I started using it there weren't many people in the UK with FBOs, so I built up my network of FBOs and then they merged two of the servers, and then people started moving in on my FBOs and undercutting all my prices, and it's like, can I be bothered with this? So I'm in two minds as to whether or not to continue my subscription. I'll get another couple of months subscription and see how we go. I might be tempted to move over to Air Hauler to get that a go. In which case it gives me another reason to stream, which is good. Checking the little nav map chart type thing. This is class D, class D airspace from 1,000 up to. Oh, okay. Because I don't have tooltips on, I don't know if I've just trimmed my rudder on my ailerons. Oh well, we'll find out soon enough. It's not pulling as far as to the left. I'm going to swap tanks, because I don't think it's swapping tanks for me. Look at that. Keep muting because I have family and they're noisy. So dogs are being walked, dogs have come back upstairs. What was I saying? I don't remember. Ah yeah, air hauler two. I don't know. I might get it. Hard to say whether I'm going to get it or not. I like the look of it. I will say that. But if that's it, I don't know if that's enough. Oh, and that golf course wasn't a golf course, it was just some fields. A green countryside is like a lot of these houses. So again, I mean, I'm on the Greek Flying Club tour for Fly UK. That's flyuk.aero, virtual airline. If I'm honest, I've not really flown enough for them recently. I feel I'll get back into it. I took a bit of a break and get all the controls mapped for the A320, the fly-by-wire, and so I've forgotten how to fly that, and then I spent a long time flying the, what's it called, the jetty thing, the Longitude, no not Longitude, the other one, the C25 Cessna, I can't remember what it's called. Anyway, I've spent a lot of time flying that, and then went into do a few tours. So I did the Alps tour, the Switzerland tour, whichever one it was, the UK, blah blah blah, and then I've not been in a jet for a long time, but you know, these things happen. I will get back into it eventually, and of course now that my settings are screwed, it makes it even more, really got a drag myself into it. I mean, I enjoy it once I'm flying. We've gained a lot of height. Didn't even notice that. I'm thinking. Oh, that would be alright. Once we get to this bit of land. Thinking at this rate, I might not get time for any elite, which is fine. Be back on it tomorrow. Long session. Mind you, we've got a lot. I'm not going to talk about elite on this. We're flying. We're on a plane. Let's leave it at that. And I didn't mute, did I? Sorry. I was going to put my head tracker on. where my microphone is, it might not pick up the head tracker properly. Although looking at it, I'm thinking, it might be okay. I'm not sure. So anyway, I'm going to relocate the head tracking camera. I'm missing my head tracking and flying. Whilst flying, gaining more altitude again. I suppose we're burning a lot of fuel, so that's why. I'm going to cut this corner, I think. I might just cut this corner. We're up at 3,000, so. Class D. Airspace. And Class D. No, we're not. That's my. I want to know what airspace I'm in. Cut off this corner. That's a good thing about being offline. As much as I love flying on bats in, when you're offline, you don't have to worry about going off route. You can just do it. You can do it anyway. In bats in, though, it's a bit more complicated. I don't know. We're gaining altitude. I don't know all the lingo. Getting there. It's only been, 20 odd years of flying online. Been more than that. I didn't fly 98 online. S9, whichever one that was, 2004. So yeah, it's just been under that, just under 20 years. auto fuel selector was on, and it keeps selecting the right tank. So we've gone through way too much fuel on the right tank. So we're going to stick on the left till we land, I think. Little things like that entertain me. I really like the little details. I've never opened that before in flight. Oh, I don't know what manifold pressures I should have or anything. But, yeah, it looks about right. I've not dropped out of the sky yet. Really very surprised at how green it is. I shouldn't be out here, there's an island. Not that one. Maybe that one actually. No, not that one. I'll be off there. I think that one there. Can you see my mouse? That island is Limnos, I believe. Let's have a look. Yeah, Limnos. That is setting for one of my other games that I've absolutely loved and got way too many hours playing, Arma 3. And just that short flight across this the sea, over to there, it's like really brown basically. Okay, what we've got coming up, we've got a 28 mile stretch coming up, 32 mile stretch coming up, down through this gap here, we will go around this point, I'm not gonna cut it off. Not too much anyway, hey. have a quick look now, whilst we've got a moment, where we're going to be landing. So I think we're going to fly straight in on this one, come down this edge of the island, straight into 1-4. And then, give it a bit of luck. If I land short enough, we'll be able to slow down and come off here. If I don't, however, we'll come off here and park in one of these spaces. I don't have any add-on scenery for this area, but anyway, it's nice enough. I think FlySim 2020 has got it right enough that most of the airports are usable, unlike FlySim X. So yeah, we'll try and come off here. If not, I mean, that looks like it's a terminal. It's GA, but we'll see. If not, we'll come off here. It's not a problem. There's no set places we need to park, you know, no ATC telling us what to do, where to go. I'm paranoid about fuel now. I keep checking the left tank, that we're on the left tank still. I didn't set the fuel for the flight length or anything. I just went with half a tank, half a load, so we should have enough to get us there. I didn't know that. So what I'm trying to do is bleed off a bit of height, a bit of altitude, coming down. Yeah, not that much, you know. Foot, 100 or so foot. You know. Is it 100? Is it right? I can never remember. Yeah, so 100 feet per minute or so. And we've got. This leg is 10 minutes, so 100 foot, it's 1,000 foot. We're not going to lose all of that. I mean, we've gone with level now, so it'll be enough to just nose down just a touch in it. So by the time we get to there, the lander should be down at 2, 1.5 maybe, and we'll just keep that descent in. Makes it sound like I know what I'm talking about. I really don't. We'll keep the descent, the very slow descent, all the way in around the. Is it that bit there? Yeah, I think it's around this bit. And then obviously we'll come in down the other side of this island where the airport is. Fly straight in. Hopefully there's no big airliners out there hitting us, waiting to fight us for the tarmac. That's how that works, how this works, isn't it? Who knows? So you call me paranoid, but I'm sure my fuel in the right tank is going down rather than left. So we're just on 10 fuel gallons. Let's remember that, 10 gallons in the right tank. We'll give it 5 minutes and then we'll see how the tank's doing. Before anybody has a panic, I'm saying the DME, I can't remember. The VOR DME, Mitalini, the airport we're heading to. Just so I've got a bearing for the airport. What I'll do is kind of set it. Let's have a look. I can set it. Attention. In fact, there's another DME. VR. That we go past. I could set the two. Apply the. No, I'm just going to VFR it. I should get the distance. Anyway, DME. I'm not sure on this aircraft where I get that. Or if I can. I was just having a fiddle with the DME. So we've got 36 miles to go. I did have a look, I think that's the heading. Oh no, that's my speed, 156 knots, and that's the heading. No, that can't be. Bear with me on this one, and I'll have a look again. So that's 7 knots, and that's how many minutes at this speed to that. But I mean, we're not going direct, so. But it's a good indication. 13 minutes, so we're looking at that. Probably about 20 minutes until we land. A little rough estimate. My paranoia is unfounded. That's not dropping. That one is. That's good, so I can stop that. I said about 20 minutes to land. I'll just set that timer to go again. We'll see how close that is. I don't know if we get the clock set on this. My yoke has got a control time on it. Doesn't seem to work with parts in 2020. I'm going for that bit around there, cut around there. Lost a bit of altitude, which is good. Oh dear, I went off on my own little world there. 6 minutes out. So, yeah, it was about right actually. 14 minutes, 15 minutes. I'm going to start slowing this down. Come over the. Yeah, we're going to pass over the city. Which is, I'm guessing. Somewhere. As we start passing over the city, we're turning towards the land. So I can't work this out. So the bit of land sticking out is there. And then the bit behind it, the city must be there. Really? Does that mean that the airport's behind this hill? Could be, I suppose. Either way, we'll start descending a bit, go down to 1,000 feet. It's like three bits of land that stick out. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So the city is actually in the third bit, which is this bit here. And then, yeah, so the airport's here. So we're going to aim to clip that bit of land there and then turn in for the final approach, I think. Or we could just go over the screw it, we'll just go over the city. That's the easiest way of doing it, isn't it? Which means I need to get losing a lot of height and speed. About 500 feet per minute. Yeah, we're getting close to it. In fact, it's descent rate of 500 feet per minute, which would give us. We're going down too slow, too fast. So we're at 1,000 feet, we're at a level out here. And slow us right down. Give a bit more power in. Just for now. City. I'm looking out for the airfield. Still, we're gaining a bit of height. I still need to lose a bit of speed. Knock that back a bit and trim up. Oh, a bit of turbulence there. So I have my my dials. Stand level, still at 1,000 feet. I'm gonna need to descend over the city. There's the airfield up on the left. Airfield's in sight. Start. In fact, we about went off the city. I descend. Still losing a bit of height, but we've adjusted for that. I will have to go quiet on the final. I'll put it right there. Gear down speed. And it's 33. I mean, we could drop it now. It wouldn't make any difference. Might even slice down a bit, to be honest. Right, there's the city. I'm going to go in over the marina. Got my big clumpy boots on, so yeah. Okay. Prop is all the way forward. Stage of flaps him. We've got one minute, 3 DME, so turn in towards the field, gear down. Down enough. There we go. Get the motors down. Second stage of flaps. Stage of flaps, I didn't mean to. Oh well, it's not a problem. Still got a bit of speed there. Let's trim for the final approach. There we go, a bit more. Again, we're aiming for this first turn off. Yeah, we're going too fast for that. Let's lose some speed. That beach looks nice, doesn't it? Wasn't a bloody road. Ah, oh well. Oh, paying attention. Yeah, we're not going to hit that first turn off. I'll hit one of these trees though, bloody hell. Okay, we came in on idle there. Brakes now. Turn. Yeah, look at that. First turn off. We made it. Oh, I can't believe we made that. So, okay, there's not as much here as I thought. But there we go. It doesn't matter. We're in. We've landed. Let's get the landing light off, taxi light on. Oh, there is no taxi light. So heat is off. I'm not paying attention to where I'm going here. We'll need to go that way. We'll go and park over here where they're telling us to park. Oh, bloody setting. I've got to find out why, what's doing that. Oh, I need to turn left up here, don't I? Get into the ramp. I can give it full left turn, but I can't give it full right turn, annoyingly. Oh well, right, into the ramp we go. I don't know if I'm supposed to go up on that line. I think I was, you know. Oh well. All over the place. Oh well, doesn't matter. Okay, that'll do us, will it? Okay, no problem. Very cool. Flaps up. Flaps up. Yeah, flaps are up. And we'll start shutting down. 1000 RPM. 1000 RPM, we'll settle it there. Let's turn the cabin and panel lights off. Another lights can go off, strobe can go off. Actually, strobe is the beacon on this flight, so on this plane. So we'll leave that on for now. Turn off the electricals. Oh, did I turn that? Oh, that's ADF, isn't it? That's I forgot what that's called. Anyway, doesn't matter. Let's turn the comm tile on. Why turn comm 2 and 1 on? So let's turn off. It'll be, I don't know what that does. I don't know if you have the proper RPM up or down when you cut the engine on this one, but we'll leave it as is. engine off. Mech's off. Turn those final few lights off, coordinator off, and battery off. And that's that flight done. Enjoyable flight. Ended up, that's quite a picturesque airfield, isn't it? I mean, the it'd be nice to have some buildings here, but there aren't. Don't know anything we can do about it. And with that, let's stop recording on that. Just filling up my power up. Say that it took an hour and 18 minutes because I was doing a bit of sightseeing. Submit that, it's been filed. I believe that's me back in good standing with the old VA. Hope so. Yep, that's me good. I'm gonna try and get back into the jets. But for now, I'm gonna call it a night on this one. And head off. I will see everybody again soon. Thank you for watching if you did. Not much I can say to people that didn't, is there? No. Bye bye.